In this video, we are going to see how the instructions are stored in main memory. So what is the logic behind that? That's what we are going to see in this video. So before going to that, let us have a small introduction. Already you have been seeing this, but anyway, I'll show you. This is our CPU 8085, and these are all the control signals. So AD0 to AD7 is address, and here A8 to A15 is again address. So A0 to A15 are address lines, and the same within that same address lines, A0 to A7 are used as data lines, data bus. Okay, so now you can see how they are directly connected to the memory, how they are directly connected from A8 to A15, whereas they are connected through a latch. Okay, from A0 to A7, they are connected to through a latch. So when this is an ALE, is nothing but address latch enable. So when this signal is enabled, the lines, the data placed from A0 to A7 are considered as address. Okay, so all these lines are address. When this goes low, when ALE goes low, address latch enable goes low, then the data present in A0 to A7 will be considered as data. So the same lines are used for dual purpose. One is for data bus, the same thing is used for data bus, as well as the same are used for lower bit of the address bus. Okay, so when it is when this acts as a data bus, that is the data, now the data will be placed. Now they will be considered as database and the data will be placed on that. Now we have two more signals called write signal and RD signal. And here this comma, that is this apostrophe says it is a, they work in lower signals. So when WR goes low only, whatever is placed on the data placed on that will be written into the memory. So let us consider this is a memory, main memory. Now RD bar and WR bar are connected to this memory chip. So these are all the main necessary things. Now you should know at this point of time how the data is returned into and read. So when the all these things, you can imagine like a page where each will be like a line. Each line will be individually addressed by the address line. Okay, so the A0 to A15, so it is 16 KB, that is 2 power 16. So the bits have 16 combinations. So 16, that is each, that is 2 power 16 unique combinations they have, right? That much lines are present. So here inside you will store 8-bit data. So what will be the capacity of this main memory? Which is nothing but 2 power 16 into 8. That will be the total capacity of this memory, right? Now, when you want to write something into the memory, you should know where you want to write, because we have seen 2 power 16 individual address lines are there. Okay, individual lines you can store in the memory, whereas 16 address lines are there. So these 16 address line can individually address 2 power 16 memory, right? So now I want to write something means, first you have to place the address on the address line. Okay, then after placing the address, once the address is stabilized, say for example, I want to write somewhere here. So that address has to be placed. In that time, all these A0 to A15 will act as an address line. Because of this, now it has to be made high. ALE is now high, so it's indicating that the data present here is a lower order of the address. Okay, so the total thing will be considered as address and the respective address will be found. After that, whether you are going to read or write, that will be done. Now, let us imagine we are going to write something into that particular address. Now, write signal is enabled. So, in that case, what happens? It understands that the data, now this acts as a data. The same A0 to A7. Now, whatever you are keeping it there, whatever you are placing, data placed, that will be considered as data. And that will be taken and it will be returned in the respective address, which you have found just now. Okay, then if you want to read something from the memory, then again the same process. First, our address will be placed from which line you want to read. So that address will be placed on the address line. Then once the address is stabilized and the particular address is found, then the same now RD bar will be enabled, that is low signal. So when it receives this, now it understands that it has to read something from that particular address, and the data which is present on the particular data address will be placed on the data bus, which in turn will be fed to the CPU for further processing. This is how it works. Now, in order to we have seen we are placing data as well as program, that is instructions, in this memory. Now we'll see how the memory is, how you can how the instructions can be placed on the memory. Now for that we should know the mnemonic. A mnemonic in the microprocessor is either a symbol, a name, or a term that defines a computer function or operation. Say if you take in C, C++, whatever language, computer language, you have some instructions, say hash include stdio.h, and then for loop, do loop, while loop, all has some syntax. All these things we call it as an instruction. So same way here in microprocessor, at a low level, when you want to write something, you can't write exactly in a binary value because the machine will accept only the binary value, which is hardly recognizable by the human being. So what we do is, other than the higher language, you'll go to the lower level language. Now, because I'm talking about the microprocessor directly, that is a machine code we are going to feed. So how machine code, when I say machine code, it is nothing but again 0, 1, but that cannot be done by a human being. So an intermediate language is nothing but our hex code. So hex code also, it is difficult for us to remember. All these hex code are supplied by the manufacturer. So what we do is we follow a set of rules called mnemonic. Mnemonic is similar to a higher level language where it has some symbol, a name, or a term. So now using that, we will write and then we will convert it into hex code, respective hex code, and then we will feed into the microprocessor, which in turn will be converted by the microprocessor into the respective binary codes, either a 0 or 1, terms of zeros and ones. The mnemonics. In mnemonics, for example, when I say R, it is used for register, A for accumulator, Z for zero flags, and add for addition. So it is an abbreviation, you can say, or something like that. So an example of a mnemonic is move. Move means moving. Instead of you give the full spelling, M-O-V-I-N-G, the respective microprocessor manufacturer, they will give us move. MOV. So this is a mnemonic of moving, which means moving data from one memory location or register to another. So now we'll see some of the mnemonics which are present as well as the hex code for the Intel 8085 microprocessor. Now if you see that, see if it is hex code is 00, then it means NOP. The mnemonic is no operation, NOP. Then 01 means LXIB, load immediate. Okay, that is the meaning. We'll see all these things later. INR is increment B. INRB means increment the data in the B register by 1. That is the meaning. INRB, after execution of this, if the B register has value 10, then after execution of this, the B register will have the value 11. Okay, so here, these are means decrement B and move immediate B, rotate left, like that. So for all these things, there is a code is there. Okay, that is a code. 06 is a equivalent code of MAB and so on. So I increment C. If I have B, the C, we know the registers are A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D, E, H, L. This is accumulator. A is for accumulator and B, C, D, E, H, L. So if you see that, that is exclusive. If you see INR, INR we have for B separate code. For INR, if you see here, we have INR C. So each we have INR B, INR C, D, E, etc. So if you take this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7. So 7 instruction which is of INR will be there. Okay, INR A, INR B, and so on. So and each has its own hex code like this. Here it has 04, here it has 0C. If you see that, next statements. See, we have D, A naught D, and so on, E, like this. Okay, so if you take decrement, the same way DCRB, DCRB, etc. will be there. If you take a move statement, see move statement. If you take move, it will be like this. Move A comma B. This is A. And then move A comma C. A comma D. And so on. It will be like this. So see here, we have move D comma B, D, D, all these D. B, C, D, E, H, L. Then memory. This is for memory. Then accumulator. Right? Then we have B, D. We have the register E. So E comma B, E comma C, E comma D, and so on. So like this combination. So for each of these things, we have a hex code. Like 50, 51. So if I want to move the value from register C to D, I have to use this hex code only. Okay. So now, whereas here, MVIB, what here, register to register transfer, it is fixed. So they have given the hex code. But if you see this, move immediate B. So from where it has to move, the data is present here itself. So for example, MVI. B means to this register, what data has to be moved? The data is present here itself. So for example, 05, which means the 05 data, after execution of this statement, the 05 data will be moved to B. After execution of this statement, B will have the value 05. Whatever the value previous, that will be overwritten. That is the meaning of this. Okay. So that is why it is given here like this. But the next argument you have to give, because it is given the user that freedom. These are all, there is no freedom. Whatever is given, the user has to, if the user wants to move a value from B to D, then he has to adopt only this statement. And then this hex code he has to replace. Whereas if you see this, the user can supply any data. That is why only for MVIB it is given. And the next one is the data has to be supplied by the user. So there are some statements like this. And then, so for example, here decrement, let us take this value itself, this value. Okay, now if you take this M, just take this M. There is no register called M. When it comes M, it is representing memory location. Okay. So the what is a memory location? What's the memory location? It consists of 16 bit. Okay. 16 bit combinations. So what happens when you have move H comma M means say for example some 8013. Let us imagine the location 8013. So it will, when it points to M, it is nothing but a memory location. So from, it means move H comma M means move the memory location. That is move the value which is stored. Say for example, here you have stored some value 10. This value after execution of this, and if the memory is pointed here, okay, if the memory address is now 8013. So where this you can find, it in the program counter. Okay, so whatever is pointed, so this data will be moved to H. After moving also, it is nothing but copy. Move statement is not exactly movement. It is only a copy. So after the execution of this statement, the value present here will be moved to that. So this is also already given. But sometimes you have some statement like this. All these are, see, wherever M comes, it is related to memory. So you will be writing the memory location, which is nothing but a 16 bit. So a 16 bit, you can write it as 8 bit.
Okay, so now I'm just giving you our just overall view. Here, these are all the instructions given by the manufacturer. Okay, you have if you want to subtract with borrow using the register E, then you have to use this mnemonic. This is a mnemonic. Okay, for human being, we can understand this, but computer can understand only this hex code, which in turn will be converted by a equivalent binary code 9B. So when I say 9B, it is nothing but see here. 9B means 1 0 0 1. Then B is 1 0 1 1. Okay, so this is what the equivalent conversion of 9B. So you know, for 9 it is 1 0 0 1, for B it is 1 0 1 1. So this is what can be understood by the computer. But you will be writing in this using mnemonic, you will be writing the program, which with the help of this instruction set, we have to convert it into physically, we have to convert it into 9B, which in turn you can feed into the microprocessor, where the microprocessor convert this into the equivalent binary code. Okay, so these are all the mnemonics, and its equivalent hex code is given like this. So you have to remember jump JMP without any condition is C3. JNZ, sorry, JNZ is when jump on no zero. Okay, depending upon the flag bits, this you can check in your logic. If you want to check the flag bit 0 bit, and then you have to change the flow of the program, then you can use JNZ. So equivalent hex code is C2 and so on. Okay. So now we'll see a small program and I'll explain. Now, this program is mainly for addition of two numbers. Now, what we have done is in B register, we are moving the value 09. So what is the statement do? MVI is move immediate. When I say immediate, that between data is present here itself. That's the meaning of this. So MVI B comma 09. So we know for MVI, it is 06. I'll show you how to find out. MVI B, see here, for MVI B, it is 06. So this is what I have written there. Okay, 06 is the opcode. Then 09 is data. So it occupies two memory space. Imagine this is the address memory location. Now it is present like this. See here, these are all the memory where these memories are used for the by the other programmers or by the operating system. The microprocessor uses this memory for some of its own internal operations. So these are, imagine these are all the user memory. After this also user memory is there and we are using this. So our data is written, you can feed the data like this only 06. It is a hex code which is equivalent for MVIB. Then since it is a 2 byte, because MVIB consists of 2 byte. For this it is 06, for this it is 09. So each occupies 8 bits. That is why they are all called 2 byte, that is 16 bit. Then MVID 05, this is also 2 byte. For MVID the equivalent is 16 and 05 is data. Then MVIC 00, this also MVIC, we have 0E and 00 is another hex code. Then move A comma B, this is already given in our because this is the register and this is a register, they know. So this is not like an user data, because since the user is giving, they have given the freedom of giving different data. So if the freedom to the user has to be given, it has to be a 2 byte. This they fix 06, but this they cannot fix. They give the user that freedom. You can have any data here. That is why this is a 2 byte instruction. For this it is a 8 bit, and for this it is another 8 bit. Whereas if you take this, only this combination is available. Move A comma B, A comma C, A comma D. So only these operations between register means the manufacturer know how many registers are there. How so all the combinations they will do, and they will give the machine code equivalent of that. So for this it is 78, and that is why it is only a single byte. Okay, 8 bit. Then add D. This is also given.
because this is fixed, this is dealing with the register. So add A, add B, add C, add D. All these things are single byte. Okay. Now, next one is move C, comma A. This is also fixed. So this is an 8-bit. Halt. With this, the program stops. So this is also an 8-bit. So wherever the user input is there, and whenever there is a memory modification, memory address itself, you are placing it here. Then address is a 16-bit, we know. Okay, address is a 16-bit plus this opcode. So totally it is a 3-byte instruction. We'll see in term. Now we'll see this program. This is for addition of two 8-bit numbers. This, say for example, in the B register, we move the value 09. Then D register, we move the value 05. Okay, so in B, you have 09. In D, you have 05. Then we are going to add these two. That is our aim. So first we clear, we in order for a temporary register, we want to keep the C as a temporary. So we clear the register C. Then what we do is move the value of, one of the value has to be moved to the occupant. You just cannot add B and D directly. One of the value has to be moved to the accumulator. So for that, we move the value of B register to A. So after the execution of this statement, our A will consist of 09. Okay. Then we have to add the value of D. So D value is there. When you give this statement, add D, which is equal to A equal to A plus D. That is the meaning of this. And the data is stored back in A. So what is A? It is already 09 because just now we have moved value B to A. So 09 plus 5, whatever is present, whatever be the execution. What is will be 09 plus 5? 09 and 05. After 9, you know, you just cannot add like a decimal. Okay, it is a hex code. So after 9, it is A. There is no 10. So A, B, C, D, E. So the value will be E. Okay. That is after 9, how you can calculate? A, 9 plus 1, it is A. Then B, C, D, E. So E is the answer. Now A has the value 0E. Now that value is moved to C. See here, after the execution, the statement, you will be having, C is having 0E. Okay, now halt. So this is how you write the code. And these are all the things which you have to, already these instructions will be given. You can have the instruction set like this. See here. Like this, you can keep the instructions with you. And then whatever the statement you have written in the mnemonics, you convert the equivalent hex code and enter into the microprocessor. This is how we do. So if you take in memory, it will be like this. Here I have written that also, but here separately I have written only the hex code. So 0609. See here, 0609. Since it occupies two memory places, see here, 800, 800, two memory space, the single instruction it will occupy. So it is a 2-byte instruction. This is also a 2-byte instruction. This is for MVI, D and 05. So it occupies two memory locations. Here also it occupies two memory locations. This MVI C and you are clearing 00. So this data also you are moving here. So it is then 78. What you are doing is move A comma B. So that is your 78. So here it occupies single memory, single byte. It is a single byte, so it occupies only one memory location and so on. Now we'll see the what is meant by, again, we have with some example, we see 1-byte instruction. Here, move C, comma A. When the both are registers itself, you can say it is a single byte. Because as I said, it is given by the manufacturer. They know what are all the registers there and what combinations they have to use. So all the combination they will use and they will give the hex code. So this is a single byte. So equivalent binary code is C. Move C, comma A means it is 4F. If you see that 40100F is this. So that's why it is a 8-bit. That is why I say this is an 8-byte
8-bit instruction, which is nothing but 1 byte. 8-bit equal to 1 byte. So I say byte means 1 byte, 2 byte means 1 byte is 8-bit, and 2 byte means 16-bit, and 3 byte is 24-bit. Okay. So when it is a 1 byte, it occupies only one memory location, because in memory you store 8 bits. Okay. So this 8-bit can be stored in a single line. Whereas if it is a 2 byte, you cannot store 16-bit in a single line, because memory itself is an 8-bit. So in the first position you can store the first opcode, and the second one it is operand you can store. So add the contents of register B to the contents of accumulator. Now what is the meaning of this add B? You have to anything. This is a accumulator. Even if the accumulator is not given explicitly, it is implied. Okay, so B value is added with the accumulator and stored back in accumulator. That is the meaning of this. So equivalent is 80H, you know, see, this is for 8 and this is for 0. Then CMA, complement A, invert. So if it is 0, then it will be 1. So whatever may be the value in the accumulator, that will be inverted. If it is a 0, it becomes 1, 1 becomes 0. So each and every single bit will be complemented. So the equivalent is 2FH. It is 2F. Now we'll see about that 2-byte instruction. Here, first byte specify the opcode and second byte specify the operand. So MBI, this is opcode and this is operand. MBI A comma data. Here you have to place the data. This is a 2-byte instruction, which means data is the user freedom. So what we do for this MBI A, it is given, because MBI A can be there, MBI B, MBI C, all the registers will come. So that is also supplied by the manufacturer. For MBI A, it may be 3E. MBI B, it may be different. Okay. But this data, this is the equivalent 3E. See, 3E. Data they have to give. That will be another 8-bit. So it occupies like this. First memory location and second, followed by the second memory location. So first byte and second byte. So how you will be writing in the memory? See here. MBIA 32H means for this it is 3E and 32 is written like this. Okay. So 3E and 32. Same way MBIB F2 means MBIB it has 06 and F2 like this. So first byte, second byte, first byte, second byte like this. So that is why it occupies two memory locations. Then 3-byte instruction. See here, jump to a memory location. You will be making, during writing a program, you may change the program flow. In that case, you will be using the jump statements. So jump to the particular memory location means you will be giving the memory location also in the instruction. So jump, for jump, they will give the hex code, because they know JMP has to be used for jump. Okay, so it is fixed. So for that, they will give. But which memory location the user will be using? While writing the program, the user may write at any places. Okay. So while depending upon his program only, he will give a jump statement. So the memory location is the user, that is allowed memory location. They will be given a set of memory locations allowed. So within those locations, he can give them memory location. So memory location is also the user has to supply. That is why. And we know memory location is a 16-bit. So that is why it is a 2-byte. This itself occupies 2-byte. This is a 1-byte. And this itself occupies 2-byte. This is again, it is in hex. So how you'll be giving C3? The equivalent JMP is C3. And for this, first you have to write the lower order bit. This is the order. Then only you have to write the higher order. So like this, you have to enter the code. So for 85, it is 8. 5 and 2020. So this is when it sees the JMP, it know that the next two data will be a memory location. The first will be the lower order bit and the second will be the higher order bit. It will know. So how you have to write it is jump 9050 means C3, JMP is C3, then 50 and 90. You have to write the lower order. Then so this will be the first byte, second byte and third byte. Like this, we have another example. Load the accumulator with the data which is present in this memory location. So here you will be giving the memory location. So from memory, see, this is our memory margin, and you have 8, 8, 5 and 0. Here you have stored some 10 margin. Now I want to load this value into the accumulator. So how I can give? This is the mnemonics. Load the accumulator
from the memory location 8850. So here I will give the memory location. So you know memory location is a 16 bit, that is 2 byte. So after execution of this statement, the accumulator, this value will be loaded into the accumulator. Accumulator will consist of the value 10.